recorded live.
Oh, What's going on, y'all out there? This is my sovereign world. Some call me Haru Aman. I am that I am. So what I was going to do is just, we was going to talk over this Wizard of Oz, kind of give you some insight. So I'm going to unmute everybody that's on the call, and we just going to go off. It's free for all, pretty much. If you got some insight on the Wizard of Oz, if you got a chance to actually read that article, and I'll real post it up again so you can actually have a chance to read it, because it was actually very informative. I wanted to say also that when I put the Wizard of Oz in symbolism, it came up 321,000 links. So think about that. Man, all this information out here. So I'm going to unmute everybody, and we can get to talking and yakking and whatever you want to go with it. So everyone's on. How's everyone doing today?
I'm fine, brother. You know your brother is always on top of things. I'm great.
That's cool. Just wanted to see what's up, see how people out there. I see Kurt One. I want to thank you coming through. Rainep. It's a couple of people on here. Just want to give a shout out to everybody. And we're going to be pretty much going over the old funnest, probably one of the most influential movies out there, The Wizard of Oz.
Absolutely, man, and that's in detail about the straw man, the tin man, tax ID number, you know, and everything else, the cowardly lion, what the lion symbolizes and everything else. It's extraordinary.
Definitely extraordinary. And what I wanted to do, I just wanted to give people an opportunity to really look at it on a deeper, you know, on a deeper level. As you've been coming into this knowledge, you know, of a sovereign or whatever the case may be, or a free man on the land, whatever you want to look at.
Right.
You know, it's definitely opportunities out there. People put these labels on you, you know, on yourself, whatever label you want, pretty much, is your choice. You, the queen, you make your own decision. But the basic idea with this book, you have changed this information. I'm going to have to start muting people.
Yeah, it looks like you might have to mute a few individuals, bro.
Yeah, so if anybody want to say something, just raise your hand with the 8. I'll leave you on, my brother Sadat, since you the active one out here.
Yeah, but you know your brother
anybody
always
else?
Active because I had the veil off of my face, bro.
I feel you. So if anybody want to make some comments, you know, to this, because we're definitely going to be going in detail. I don't know if you got a chance to look at that link, emancipation2.com, wizard.html. But if you get a chance, go ahead and read it. It's definitely informative. And that's just one site. It's other sites out there available, too, as well. So we just wanted to get in detail really what the Wizard of Oz, really the symbolism behind it. Not just this movie, but other movies as well, you know.
Absolutely.
So I had some notes. I took some notes myself during the movie and whatnot, and I kind of wanted to go over my notes, and maybe if that's sparking somebody's, you know, ideas or concepts, hey, you always can hit *8, and I'll let you available on the site or let you get on, let you talk to us a little bit and get some insight. So The Wizard of Oz, I was doing some homework on the original author of the book, the original author of the book. And the play, whatnot, you know, is L. Frank Baum, if that's
yep.
how you pronounce his last name.
Yeah.
And he wrote The Wonderful Wizard of Oz and a couple other different books on that particular subject. But what we fail to realize is that he's from a wealthy family. You know, he comes from a wealthy family. So he did have a little insight on some information on what was available. His father was actually made his money through oil. Is anybody there?
Yeah, I'm here, brother. I was just trying
okay.
to let you get through.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah. So he just was
family, right?
No, so he hit it off through the oil, became wealth. His father became wealthy through the oil industry, Pennsylvania, and that kind of paints a picture right there. So we never really look at the root of where these stories are coming from, literally the creators. So that's what I was kind of trying to open the door open, you know, get people to see the more inside of what's going on in detail. So he did have access to information, certain information like the Rockefellers and, you know, some of their plans they was putting on and doing back in the day, you know. So it's kind of interesting because you think he probably foretold this information. It already was being said already, but he foretold it in a storyline or a play, just like you see today, cartoons and everything.
Exactly. They
saw all these metaphors and symbolisms all through these cartoons, but, you know, as they say, you got to give it to the people softly, huh?
Yeah, you have to give it to the people softly. Well, not only that, but it's extraordinary in the context of him having ideas about how the fragmentation and absolutely the things that they were going to do as far as the stock market crash, the factual bankruptcy of the government,
mm-hmm.
and everything else that ensued after that. So he's kind of really sharing secrets among those of himself who are illuminated to this level of metaphors and riddles and sleight of hand, as I call it, because you have to remember that. And I love my Jewish brothers and sisters because I have many of them who are friends of mine. But them keeping the covenant with God actually gives them an understanding on finances, on dealing with your own personal affairs, and looking at things in the realization of as they are by research and study. And those are the main things that we have been kind of brought away from in terms on our sojourn here in the country by not being able to read, not being able to document information, not to be able to keep historical and cultural facts the way that they are. So they've been able to do it on the level of understanding that the OZ in Oz means ounce. The yellow brick road actually in the field was trying to get people to follow the yellow bricks. What's the gold? Who stole the gold?
Indeed.
Follow the yellow brick gold and take it to where the gold is going. You know, who was the wizard? Why was he veiled and behind a curtain? You know,
exactly.
the illusion of us all being Dorothy, you know what I'm saying, and going into a sleep state or going into actually an alternate reality away from the true nature and the true reality of what's supposed to be the life that we're meant to have. So here it
exactly.
is that. Here it is that they've used those very metaphors, those very illusions to create not only their own wealth, but to create a status for themselves on a level where they've empowered themselves to be rulers of the planet. So this guy, Frank Baum, was actually taking the film or taking the storyline and sharing it with those who had enough sensibility to look for themselves, which is what we're all supposed to be doing, to find your own self-remedy, to find the own things that will create the type of life and manifest the type of well-being that you could. But you have to study, you have to be still, and you have to be cognizantly aware of and have an open mind to all and any information that you might be privy to and how to discern it. So here it is, they're showing us how to follow the yellow brick road, the fact that we're in a sleep state as Dorothy, the fact that we all have a straw man attached to us that doesn't have a brain, of course. We have a tax ID number, of course, that doesn't have a heart, because the heart itself would give you the type of energy and the understanding of how to acknowledge the things around you and its resonance if you're paying attention to your heart. And let's say your brain. Look at those two items. Here it is. Straw man needs a brain. The tin man needs a heart. And, of course, the cowardly lion needs courage. Yet he's a lion because they've attached him as an animal to this whole thing by saying that the whole human family is just chattel animals or just basically cows or lions. In the picture, in the movie, of course, it was a lion, him being king of beasts and not king of beasts because he had no courage. It's just showing you how these illusions themselves have truth, and truth and righteousness resonates in everything around us. It's just a matter of, are you on that particular vibration to get the understanding from it?
Exactly. And the coolest thing, the other side of the lion as well, is that that's you, the American people. You have that opportunity. You make the choice. You make the choice. You make the laws, but you're giving them the access to make the laws. You're giving this so-called government the access to make the laws on you.
Yeah.
what you need to be doing instead of the other way around. That's the issue. That's what I got out of the. And it's funny too, because when you look at the movie, literally, when you look at the movie and listen to the content, people, if you don't get nothing else out of My Sovereign World Talk Show, listen to the content of what we actually explaining, and listen to the content of the movies. The movie
Absolutely.
Is actually telling you your story. It's actually telling your story. Even the metaphor of the black and white in the beginning, even though that was put in later on, in I think in the 50s, it actually was put in, the color was put in there, far
yeah.
in the movie. But when you yeah. look at it, it's showing you metaphorically black and white. Everything is black and white at the beginning in Kansas. Then it's colored in Oz. Come on, look at what our
yeah.
fictitious person, or look at what our straw man goes through. It's all
beautiful.
Made up. It's all
yeah.
made up for the straw man.
Yeah, it's all made up by the straw man. And then at the same time, it's just so significant in what you said, my brother, because it's trying to tell us and relate us to truth. By letting us know that in the beginning, everything was in black and white. So here it is that you can read it and understand it and get its understanding in black and white. Then here they come with the colorable law. So they color things the particular way they wanted to. They made it an illusion, you know. They wanted the house to fall on the witch and the ruby slippers to no longer be ruby, but they were actually silver. They turned ruby after a long time. Some other history
come
in terms
on
the film. Then here it is, you have the witch who was trying to get Dorothy. Here it is. Dorothy is asleep, you know. She doesn't know what's going on, so she's not
dreaming.
Of herself, like many of us are, the people. We're in a
dreaming.
Dream state, right? So here it is. She's in black. She's in all black as the witch. She has the black robes like the judges and the lawyers and attorneys and things and people who are doing this colorable process. So she told Dorothy, I want Toto. Toto is a Latin term for totally everything you own. It means in total. I want everything you have in total. So that's why she was after the little black dog, Toto, because she wanted to take everything in Dorothy on as a means for her own power, empowerment as the Wicked Witch of the West. And I wonder, why was it in the West that the witch was wicked? Are we in the West here in the United so-called states?
Yes. Come
so
on.
We're in the West with the wicked. Here we are in the West with the Wicked
and,
Witch.
And you see who they killed first. You see who,
exactly.
Dorothy smashed first. Come
the,
on.
The good witch. One of the good witches, right?
Of the E.
You know?
She hit the E. She hit the E.
You know,
first.
She was
got
in the E. Where all the knowledge is at, where all the wisdom is at, and all the understanding is at, let's get rid of the E first and turn everything to the West.
Exactly. So they know, I mean, metaphorically, they've been doing this very strategically since throughout the time of the inception
Absolutely.
Of America. But it's been
Absolutely.
Way before even the inception of America. I mean, 500 years later, before they even had America, or so-called America, claiming America over here, they literally had these laws in place. You know, they knew what was what was going on. Like Bob,
exactly.
Frank,
exactly.
he knew eventually that the bank system will end up stealing the people, or putting the people in slavery, back into slavery on a massive level, you know, really taking them from out of their, because, I mean, the example is slavery. When you look at slavery in general, that was the
yep.
example. They were just mastering the system.
Exactly.
That's all.
Exactly.
You know?
And as they've evolved with the system, they've newly created artificial Americans that were really former sovereigns, you know, but now you have no brain and you're too confused and distracted by all the commotion that's going around you and chaos to even figure out that you had a straw man who was the scarecrow, of course, in the movie that was identified in the movie, you know, scarecrow not having a brain. And he always sang throughout the movie the classic song, If I Only Had a Brain. And that's the thing. If we only had a brain, how we could unravel every riddle and create everybody to be able to protect themselves from any legal troubles or legal damages, because remember, the witch is in the black robes like the judges. So she's really truly after the people. Then she have all of her security forces, the winged monkey and the guards that's at the post. The guards are right there at the court, and they telling you your doom as you come up to the court. Oh, Leo. Leo, you know, oh, it's me. Oh, it's me, right? So here it is. You got to go into the darkness and the caverns of the court system with the hourglass steady going as they get you out of the court, not knowing that at any time we could pour water on this punk and he'll melt right in our hands.
Come on, come on. And that brings me to the part when the Wicked Witch, or I forgot the lady's name now, but who came to the house at the beginning in the black and white
right.
section.
Exactly.
Came
exactly.
to the house, she said to Annie M, said, we can't go against the law. Think about this.
Right.
Because of preserved values and all these things, but the so-called, you are the law, you are the authority. That's what we got to realize, who we are as sentient beings, or who we are as sovereign men and women. Or gods and goddesses, period. You have
Absolutely.
That right to make your own law. As long as you're not killing nobody, nobody's killing anybody, you got that right, period,
Absolutely.
Point blank. You know, and these are things we just, and I think this is where our so-called beliefs, our value systems, our morals, you know, all this stuff is getting in our way because we're, if I can't do this because I believe this, and I do this because I believe this. See, we got to start questioning that belief as well. You know,
Absolutely.
That's the whole point of what My Sovereign World is here for, to start asking those questions, start posing those questions and challenging the people. Hey, all the things I've been raised up with, or the knowledge and all what my parents been giving me, was that right? Think about it. Was it right, or was it the way I should be, or is this what I need to be doing? Can I question it? You know, here's an opportunity to question it right now. This government is feeding us. This government is housing us. This government is wiping our asses, people. Come on. When are we going to wake up and start... start telling them I can do it myself.
Exactly. At some point, we're going to have to grow to the realization that we are not the tin man, T-I-N, tax
come
ID
on,
number.
Come on.
So here it is, he hollow, you knock on the brother, and you hear all this echoes and stuff. And he really was showing us a hollow man made of metal, which was really a vessel or a vehicle. Which was coded words also for a straw man. So just like the straw man had no brain, the tin man had no heart. And both of these creations was what? They was artificial people. So now everybody is an artificial person on paper with that tax ID number and that straw man that is in D.C. with a receipt on it that is on the back of your birth certificate. So none of us live in the states that we live in when we don't understand that we're legal fictions or artificial manifestations of government and commerce. So here it is that you don't even realize that at the time of you walking around right now assuming that you are doing what you do individually or on your own or anything, you actually are in that docile dream state like Dorothy, and you definitely have a straw man, you definitely are the tin man, and you certainly don't have any courage because you haven't stepped out of your own fear to truly see what's going on. So here it is,
and
we're off to see the wizard.
And that's right there. That's exactly right there. We sit up here, we have the power, and we can't say it enough. Like, and we're going to be actually doing a, we're going to be doing a special talk show just on self-empowerment and point blank, self-empowerment, because it's all about self-empowerment, period.
Absolutely.
You know what
Absolutely.
I'm saying? When you're talking about you have the power, you literally have the power. You just got to step up and take that responsibility, you know, and that's all Dorothy did when she tapped her shoes. She finally realized that she had the shoes. She had the power right there in her feet.
Absolutely.
Or in her head.
Right. And what color were they? They were ruby red for blood.
Come on.
Ruby red.
And the original, yeah. And it's definitely, I mean, you always had the power. She always had the power to go home.
Always have had the power.
You know, it just didn't, she didn't realize it. And that's the whole point of, like they say, when the messenger comes, the student will step up. Is that,
yeah.
I'm
Absolutely.
Just rephrased, you know, that's definitely, you know, and that's what we're here for. This is what we're here for. Not necessarily, maybe not for you. It might be for somebody else on the call. I don't
right.
know.
Right. But remember, that whole thing that, and the whole thing is, and one of the things that we've really been stressing and studying is to understand the definitions of these words and understand
words.
Their etymology, see, because here it is, 10. 10 is defined in Webster as counterfeit. So the 10 man represented the mechanical and heartless aspect of commerce and commercial law. And it's nothing personal. It's all business. Because modern commercial law has dominion over civilization and citizens when they don't understand who they truly are as being one of God's creations. So you've always been empowered by our Father who is God. How are we in his image and his likeness? How could you be in God's image and likeness and yet you're a straw man or you're a tin man? Then somebody's lying. Somebody's made you an artificial person and have recreated you. So who are we empowering by allowing them to recreate the very thing, the very nature, the very trait and characteristic that we had as being gods? And that's
you can't
thing.
Serve two masters, and you can't serve two masters. It's no way. You know, it's no way. I mean, you are the master, so you got to step up to that game. You got to step up to that plate, you know.
Yeah,
and the beautiful thing, like I said, the beautiful thing, just like Wizard of Oz, because literally what they're talking about, even when you listen to the straw man, what he's actually saying, he's saying, well, I have a brain. People have a brain and they talk too much. Think about that. Think about that.
Here's one better than that metaphorically. Here it is. We got to follow the yellow brick road, right? So we can find out the trail. We can keep our nose to the ground on the trail of who stole the gold. So here it is, the yellow brick road. Yellow bricks is gold, right? And who was the thief that stole it? And at the beginning of the movie, remember the wizard who was behind the counter, he was called Professor Marvel, right? And Professor Marvel was talking about that he just had the crown heads of Europe, the past, the present, and the future, and that, wow, I am the professor who is the monarchs of Europe, and I've looted their kingdoms, right?
Yes.
I'm one of the international people who is a part of Isis, Osiris, and the days of the pharaohs in Egypt and stuff. He was just telling her all kind of snake oil stories and everything. So here it is. He's giving us stories to continue to massage us into that sleep state. So they tell us about the Easter Bunny or Brother Yeshua's resurrection, or that you have to have a Christmas tree with lights and stuff and a big white guy's coming down the chimney and stuff and a bright red suit now. To bring gifts to your children after y'all done work overtime for a whole year to make sure your family have these provisions, right? So here it is. We keep getting all these telltale. Oh, I forgot. By the way, the earth was flat. And if you get to the end of the earth, you're going to fall off the edge. So we have to remember where all these circumstances, stories are coming from, and what are the illusions behind them, and are they folklore or are they real?
Yeah.
So just to give you an idea on how we've been hoodwinked, bamboozled, and used as the collateral and the surety of the country who's borrowing money from private families and private banks has been an extraordinary process of consciousness that is now coming retroactively because the people's resonance is at a higher vibration. So here it is.
Yes.
And we pull that cover off that wizard and we looked at his name was Oz, which is ounces of gold. We figure out that here it is that Dorothy and her friends were even being used, right? So they use everything on us. They use spiritually enhanced drugs from cigarettes to alcohol to marijuana to heroin, whatever. So here it is. They go through the poppy fields in the movies, and all of them fall asleep because they were trying to get them high too before they found out what was real and what wasn't. So that's another example that the brother put in the movie.
Oh, big time.
So
big time.
When here it is, we go right through the forest, right? And we get to the forest where the poppies at. Now, poppies make heroin, morphine, and opium. So they go through the poppy fields, and everybody knocked out because they so high from the poppies. So that's just another thing he was showing us, how they even use drugs and even have us using, you know, chemically medicating ourselves to leave from the reality of the discomfort of debt and chaos that's created on us because we think everything around us is money and there's no money.
Hey, and check this out. On that metaphor on the poppies, think about this. All the people, all the ones who fell out, cocaine, all the ones who fell out were the real flesh and blood.
Exactly.
Flesh and blood. They was flesh
right.
Man
right.
and woman.
The only thing that fell was one animal, the damn lion, because hell, he's close to us, right? And just nature in general. But the artificial being shit, they still was running that tax man ID number on your behind while
come
you
on
these drugs and you asleep and you knocked out by all the chemical warfare that they create over you. And here it's just the 10 man still getting his on.
Exactly.
And the straw man is still trying to find that brain because he's still, hey, he's being utilized too. So these factors shows exactly how illusion, subliminal messages, rituals, traditions, and history, those things are used to continue to keep the people from incapable of being the reflections in God's image and likeness that they truly are. So how would the people know, just like in Scripture Hosea says, they destroy themselves from the lack of knowledge. They have no idea what's going on or what's happening.
And they're genius. When you think about it, they're geniuses. When they invented that TV and when they invented that radio, they
all
said,
day.
Now we really going to take over.
All day. Because here it is. Here's a visual vibration, you know, and a frequency vibration. Because the radio, hell, you got amplitude modulation. You have frequency modulation. AM, amplitude modulation. FM, frequency modulation. So here it is. They are actually modulating the frequencies that are bouncing these particular vibrations or frequencies or tones off your mind to continue to inhibit you from using your own resonance of thought so that you can vividly look at truth and righteousness the way it is.
No doubt. No doubt on that. No doubt on that, brother. I mean, it's so cold. And what this was, I was trying to get people to really think about this. Why they call the West the wicked witch? They said the wicked witch, not just the witch. They said the wicked
the
witch.
The wicked witch of the West, right?
Think about that, people. Think about that. You know, the wicked witch. And we sit here and we praise this. I mean, we praise, oh, I'm American. I'm proud to be American. You know, you that whole ideology. I don't know if you've seen Esoteric Agenda. For all of you who haven't seen it, it's actually available on YouTube as well.
Yeah.
But it's definitely a great video to watch. Something you definitely got to check out. And it actually breaks down some of the metaphoric types or the symbolism, a lot of the symbolism that's going on, even though symbolism's always been there regardless what we think, but, you know, it's right there in front of our face every day, 24/7.
Exactly, and so that's why it's extraordinary in context, the film itself, as I spoke of earlier about, for instance, like the ruby red slippers, you know, actually, in an older Wizard of Oz film, the slippers actually were silver. They were silver slippers,
yeah,
that they went along the Yellow Brick Road. So here it is. We're looking at the gold and the silver. So, of course, some people got wise of it, so they changed the silver slippers to actually ruby red slippers, but they still left a clue. You know, and the clue is that, remember, that blood is red, and on all documents that you file, red is a very significant. That color signifies the private as opposed to public use of your Social Security card. That's why I have red serial,
yes,
number on the reverse. And registered mail that you send your documents in is red registered mail sticker, which is the real United States Post Office Department rather than Postal Service. So they've changed everything, created the illusion, and had the people lulled to sleep in the traditions of what government is supposed to have been about. So it's a shame that we even battle some of our own brothers and sisters and them thinking that they're with the government, they're for the government, and they'll fight us tooth and nail about something they assume is the truth when we're reality, it has all of us at odds.
Yeah, indeed, indeed. It's definitely there. I mean, like I said, everything's in front of us. All the information has been spit out, but it's been all fun and games, and that's why the entertainment world is so huge, you know, because it's all been sport and play. You know, everybody want to go play and have some fun, but then when it's really time to play and have some fun, you know, you got all these big conglomerate families, multi-billionaire families that's been rich. Man, they ain't caring about all that stuff. Long as I'm getting my check, long as my money is in my bank, I'm cool. You know,
yep,
we running out all these holidays. We going out. These holidays, the holidays all made up, people, and we can't even see that. It's all about spending your money, going buying something for. You love your mom every day, 24/7. You showing you appreciate your mom every day. That should be a given.
Right. And remember, okay. See, and remember when you go to court, you know, you're considered to be a child. You're considered to be a child or a ward of the state or somebody who doesn't know any better. And here it is, you had the Munchkins, who basically reflected of the children. Here the Munchkins, they're singing and their glory of the wizard's creation. Oh, the wizard created the Emerald City, the City of Green, Federal Reserve. They're just dancing and joyous because the wizard has created money for us. You know, we're all okay. We're out of the dark, and this is the most glorious place on earth. This beautiful green city with this green money that the wizard has made for us. You know, after he walked you through the poppy flowers and stuff, because he was trying to really make Dorothy unconscious so he could snatch the slipper from her butt before she got to the Emerald City, you know. But like you said, all the flesh and blood entities were the ones who could only be drugged, actually. And then, of course, they cried out for the good witch of the north, who answered their prayers with snow so that the narcotics effect of the poppies could wake Dorothy the lion
cocaine,
and the dog because they were only living beings, right? So anyway, here it is. We get to Emerald City, and of course, everything is in color again. Wow, there goes a horse of a different color. The horses were yellow, purple, green, blue, red. You know, we're still in a colorful atmosphere. Everything is all illusion. Where the color is symbolizing the planet. And the judges and the priests and their robes and stuff, you know, and all these types of things, man. So you really have to really understand that the sheriff was really demanding that Dorothy surrender totally all her money. Remember when the sheriff came to the farm after the witch, her name was Almira Gulch, you know, who was Annie M's neighbor, who was just one of the mean ladies with the long nose. She owned half of the country, right? So here it is. Yeah. We got Rockefeller and Rothschild representation and Almira Gulch, the witch, right? So she comes and she say the sheriff comes with her, the sheriff, demanding that they surrender total to her custody. So all of Dorothy's value and her worth and the farm's worth was total. That's what Toto means. The little dog Toto means total. It's a Latin term for total. That means everything you own. So the sheriff came for the dog, remember, after Mrs. Glutz's allegations about the dog biting her. Oh, by the way, she bit me. You know, that's why we're going to get this little. I'm going to get that little dog. I'm going to take you totally. And she, you know, her aunt, of course, is just like our moms and dads. Well, we can't keep them from taking Toto, y'all, because we can't go against the law, so let's surrender our dog. Dorothy, I'm afraid that Toto going to have to go. We're going to have to get Toto to this wicked witch, you know.
She told her,
here's the judge, right? Not with the robe on, though, you know. And a lot of people didn't understand that. Now, here it is in the beginning of the film. It's in black and white, right in our face. Now, the wicked witch became the judge with the robe on, after they started using colorable law in the film, when the film went to color.
Come on.
Then she had a black robe on. But in the meantime, she was derobed in the beginning of the film, and yet she said that if you don't hand over that dog, I'll bring a damn lawsuit against you, which will take your whole farm. So another tactic in coming and taking all of your stuff, because remember, 95% of all lawsuits in the world are filed under U.S. jurisdiction, man. So we need to think about that. And 70% of all the attorneys in the world reside where? In the West, in America.
Come on.
So here it is, the wicked witches of the West. And here they are in their watchtower where the guards are and the winged monkeys. And now behind it's like left and right with the color choice of judges and priests with their robes. Don't forget the priests have black robes too. Well, they have colorable robes, let's put it that way. But a long time ago, most priests had black robes too. Now they have color robes. You know, your church might have purple and gold, or red and gold, or white and gold. Everything's colorable now, because remember, we're an illusion. We're not in the real black and white world, because people won't crack a book and read the black and white.
And that's that's the sad thing about it, because all the secrets, all the explosion of the lies are right there in those books.
Exactly.
You know, regardless of what anybody say, that's what anybody it's right in those books, man. And what's cool about it, they gave it to you free at a public library. Think about that. A public library. You got libraries on the corner in your, I hope in your city. I mean, you should. And then you have the law library that's available, and it should be free to you. You know,
exactly.
So all the right there in front of us, we just got to go. You got to put action to it. Kind of like if Michael Jordan wanted to be the best ball player, he had to put work in, right? Kobe Bryant claimed he's the best basketball player. Prove it.
Okay. And that's why in the beginning, remember, the Wizard in the beginning, he was a snake oil salesman, you know? And he told him he was going
to... Oh, repeat that? I'm sorry.
I said the Wizard was a snake oil salesman. He was a confidence man. Remember, in the beginning of the film, the Wizard was the guy who had to fuck with all this stuff. And he said that he was going to help the straw man get a brain and go to the universities. You know, the land the land of E Plubus Unum, which is the Latin term out of many, right? And converting many into one New World Order, Novus Ordo Seclorum. You know, so these Latin phrases are on the American dollar bill shortly after bankruptcy for a reason. They reveal and they confess a lot of things if you're able to read vividly like you're supposed to. Remember, there are always illusions, like that pyramid that's on that dollar. How can that pyramid have a shadow cast underneath it if it's on the ground?
A shadow in general, you think of a shadow, that seemed like some crooked stuff to me.
Absolutely. Well, I just thought I'd throw that out there for some of the people who, you know, might be paying attention, right? But that's a whole other issue, man, because the whole gang, Dorothy and her whole crew fell for the Wizard's illusion, man, all the way until they got there with the damn pull of curtain. And remember, he was going to let them get caught up because... The first time they had talked to him, they couldn't see him, and he made them go back to mess with the witches. He sent them back to court to mess with the judge and get that broom, right? You have to come back here with a broom to show me that you got a remedy so I can show you what's happening. Show me proof that you talked to the witch, right?
It's kind of like, for example, it's kind of like following that UCC-1 or following your public law.
Public
law to... That's what that was going on right there.
So he said they get ready to pull the cover off of him, and he shook him up because he sent him away again to go mess with that judge and give me that broom, and then I'll holler at y'all the next time. But he didn't know they was going to make it back, though.
Yeah, exactly. And that's it.
You know,
that's what we always talking about, standing on your square. You got to stand up. You got to stand up to this, you know, to this, whatever it may be, because what they're killing you through the paperwork. That's where they're getting you. They ain't getting
you
no other way. They're getting you through that paperwork, these contracts you sign, you know, these agreements we sign, 24 hours. And Kurt, Carnegie, I'm definitely pretty savvy with Carnegie donating all to the public libraries. That was his way to give back to the people, so-called, because all the things he was doing, all that crooked stuff he was doing back in the day.
Absolutely. But not only give back to the people, but look, see, it goes deeper than that. Because even in terms on the information that the people were using, he had to covertly use his story as a means of control, too. So even the books that he had given to the people were tampered with. They weren't real. They didn't have all the truths that were supposedly have. But even the truth that they had, they still had to have some kind of capability of decoding, just like you always say, of decoding those items, too. And that's why he gave those books up. Because you got to remember, we're here. Remember, the Good Witch, who was called Glinda, was the Good Witch of the North. That's what all that's at in North America. So here it is, the Good Witch of the North gives us Santa Claus and Christianity as a way to help us get back to Kansas, right? Because we all still sleep. Come on, man. So here it is, they're still giving us illusions as a way to keep the people from understanding what they need. But also the Good Witch told Dorothy, you don't need to be helped. You have always had the power to go back to who you were or to go back to Kansas. You've always had the power within yourself. You've always had your own capability within you to get back to wherever you want to be at or to be whatever you want to be, and that means everything.
in toto, so to speak.
Yes, indeed, brother. It's all telling us. I mean, those of you on the phone call, it literally, I mean, something obviously already awoken you. And, you know, I mean, you're here for a reason, obviously. It's some deeper thought, though, but it's funny because it's really not deep when you think about it. It's just stuff we haven't been aware of, that's all. Just information we haven't been aware of. And like I say, the Kemet people, they only gave, you know, 10% of the knowledge. They didn't give it all, the 360 degrees. So that's the understand. That's the decodation right there, you know.
And the people have always had the right and the power to reclaim their sovereignty, man. They just forgot the actual facts of that process, you know, which is extraordinary in this context, because wizard means what it means. A wizard is a person of high professional skill or knowledge. So here it is. We often see the wizard, a person of high professional skill or knowledge, but yet a person. Remember, which is an artificial being. He isn't even real. So even his professional skill and his knowledge is not capable of surpassing ours when we recognize who we are as spiritual beings rather than a person, which is a legal fiction. So the wizard just being a person of high professional skill and knowledge just shows that he, too, in a sense, is an artificial illusion. And where is his high professionality coming from in skill? And where is his knowledge coming from in skill? Hell, it's the IRS, a private collection agency for the private Federal Reserve Bank. That's who the hell the wizard is. He got first-hand knowledge of the mechanics and laws of commerce, man. And he religiously going to do that to the unregistered foreign agents that he have at the IRS service and the Federal Reserve. Here it is, people that ain't even got no business in our country running the country.
Yeah, like LaRouche.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
I'm trying to be funny, y'all, but LaRouche, he got so much of influence over in this country. I'm wondering how this dude doing it. He got a whole crew. They be at every college, every schoolhouse, putting it down.
Putting it
this
down.
This dude don't even live in the country.
And if you can sort some of the information, or you can really get a good understanding out the information, he's thumbing his nose and putting it right in your face to show that the people is lost and turn out. We'd be so hostile with some of them LaRouche people and the information they have, and yet the key to this technological-based consciousness we have right now, the keys to everything that's going on right now is information, 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 information.
Come on.
Right now is the very resonance and consciousness that's going on, because technologically there is no information that could be veiled now. So everything and anything that is about to be learned to consciously bring the people to the wisdom, knowledge, understanding, and the independence that they need, or the awakening that's taking place right now, is in the information age. It's all around us. It can't be stopped. It can't be hidden. Nobody can claim rights to it anymore, because that's where the consciousness is right now, the information age. So people better be trying to get as much information as they can and much knowledge as they can find, and then determine what paths of enlightenment that will allow them to truly be free.
Let me just put this out there. I want to welcome you all to My Sovereign World once again, and I want y'all to do your own research. These are just some thoughts, ideas, concepts, you know, that we're talking about, literally, about the Wizard of Oz and other different remedies and different ideas, concepts, and whatnot. So just wanted to make sure you have that understanding or decodation of what's really going down here at My Sovereign World.
Absolutely.
So just want, you know, because I really think, you know, we go out, this is a problem I see. We can go get all the latest technology in the book. I mean, get the new iPhone, get the new iPad, new this, new that,
right,
new that.
Right.
But how many people actually go out? Like the other day, man, I went to the library, 50 cents. I found a book, 50 cents, believe it or not, people. And this book is actually a remedy book in law. 50 cents, Business Law Principles and Cases, Third
yep.
Uniform Commercial Code Edition. And this was
wow.
back in 1954. 50
wow.
cents sitting at. That's what I'm just telling you. All opportunity is there. You got to go find it, though. Because opportunity
yep.
ain't going to. opportunity is just not going to lay in your, well, it does come to your doorstep, but you,
yeah,
if you can't recognize it, you're not going to see it.
Exactly.
So that's,
but the funny part about you mentioning that is the fact that here it is again, we're off to see the wizard. So
exactly.
If people really are following the yellow brick road and you're off to see the wizard, remember that he was a professionally skilled, knowledgeable person, and he was able to do what he needed to do in a world that he was had hidden from other people. So here it is, my brother find a book with extraordinary information on it for 50 cents because it has no value to the people because the people will not crack a book and read.
Exactly.
iPod,
and that's
360.
Come on.
Cable
to,
TV.
Like I said, we're quick to get that new stuff, but we ain't quick to put new stuff in our brain or new information or usable information in our brain.
Exactly.
You know,
exactly.
I mean, our brains can hold much as these computers, you know, gigabytes, billions and billions of gigabytes. If you want to go there, you know.
Billions.
And we sit up here, just think about all the processes and conditioning what we've been going through with our parents and mom, all these different societies and institutions we've been dealing with, and churches and mosques and temples and all this stuff, but we separate it somehow. You see what I'm saying? We separate the information somehow. We put it in a section. Okay, we use this for when we need this. We use this for when we need that. We still can do that. That was the whole greatest thing about Kemet or Egypt, you so-called call it today. But that what the information they gathered in that last 3,000 years, during that 3,000-year period, their goal was to literally understand the knowledge, the wisdom, what's going on with the world. That was their that was their goal, period. We forgot about that. Our goal is to get the latest, man, I'm going to go pick up that new Mustang.
Okay.
That new Camaro. Or
okay.
That new iPod that came, or iPad, or whatever you want to call that crap.
Yeah, because they've been allowed to think that trinkets and material things that are outside of themselves, artificial things, just like themselves being an artificial person when they go to these courts, the artificial things are a way of life. It's a tradition. It's the way to be. So this week, let's go get all the Air Maxes. Our whole community go get the new Air Maxes. Matter of fact, don't get the Air Maxes. Let's go get the new Jordans. Everybody go buy the new Jordans. Oh, I forgot that Eve got finished out. Let's go buy some of her clothes to get butt-naked too, by the way. You know, so let's go and create all these. Oh, I forgot to pay my rent. I forgot to pay the bill, Dad. I forgot to pay for our cable. The cable's off, but I do got these new gym shoes, though.
But it
so
comes down
it
to value.
That
it comes down to what you value, though.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
It comes down to what you value. Because, see, me personally, I value books. I mean,
me too.
Value books. I got e-books like crazy, thousands and thousands of e-books.
Me too, bro. Thousands of books. I have thousands of books in my library. I own the bookstore in Chicago. Hell, I got all that stuff.
Exactly. And, I mean, that's what I value. I always value books.
Absolutely.
Just I don't get into all the other materialistic stuff because it is not needed. Yeah, I got a nice Mac. Okay, cool. But that's a tool. That's how you got to look at it. It's a tool. And just that's all the Wizard of Oz is another tool for us to really think about who we are.
Absolutely, man. And it's so strange because the Department of Treasury, you know, they got all these return. You know, a lot of people don't know how to fight these people back, but anytime they putting these stamps on these letters and stuff and sending them out to you, that's mail fraud right there. That's a counter mail fraud that you can use as remedies for certain things, infractions that the IRS give you with their false impression. But last year, let's say the fiscal year 2006, the IRS collected $133,917,000 individual income tax returns. From those tax returns, which was illegally collected, they got over $1.2 trillion from those returns. Per return, per person in the United States, all these millions of people, that was about $9,000 per person that was illegal, that went right to a private bank, to private citizens, to private people who are controlling this whole globe commercially. I mean, the Federal Alcohol Administration, who is even operating under colorable law, you know, they were declared unconstitutional when the IRS tried to get foreign international bankers to operate out of certain areas of the world, and it was unconstitutional. So now that's when you have a war on crime and a war on drugs. Hell, they can't give us any money, so let's make a war on that. You know, we can't tax them, you know, while they're getting high off all these products and stuff to grow out of the ground naturally, right?
Oh, come on.
We can't get no money from them, so that's illegal. Let's have a war against the drugs. You know?
See, and this is the key. I think this is key, too. We, as people, are sentient beings, or wherever you want to go with it, wherever you want to be called, I am that I am, as we say. The key element is this. You don't have no debt. You don't have no debt. You don't even exist. If you want to go there, you don't even exist as a straw man. So why do we want to claim the straw man? Why do we want to even control the straw man? Why not just exit out the whole system and be cool with that? And but we can do it as a collectively, privately. We can come together privately and contract with each other privately. Why not?
Yep. I agree, bro. But you know something?
I mean,
it's funny how they still are in the habit. See, this is like the same thing with drugs, right? So here it is that we're addicted to Federal Reserve notes or addicted to money as a means of getting items or living. So they have to be taken through a withdrawal process away from the money or understanding transactions, bartering, or exchanges in the first place. Here it is, we're really supposed to be using bill of exchanges to create zero bookkeeping entries, and yet we would rather have thousands and thousands and millions of dollars in greenbacks that aren't worth anything to create the type of wealth and material things that we have around us that are an illusion. So they have to have a withdrawal away from that whole process in order for them to collectively create the groups that we say can exchange individual talents and individual skills as a means of all of us being okay. And it's going to at some point have to happen because, hell, they might make a law whereas that it's against the law to barter. You can't go over your neighbor's house to borrow something. He can't exchange something for what they're doing. You either go out here to this bank and get some of my money, else we're going to lock you up in jail.
The only thing they can do that, only time they can do that for is a U.S. citizen if you want to claim yourself as a U.S. citizen.
Yep.
You know? That's really where it's going to come down to. And that's what we're starting to see now with all the Restore Republic and all these different issues going down.
Yep.
Hey, we know supposedly, I don't think they're accurate, but we all know the 2012 issue. I don't know if that's accurate or not. I doubt it. But eventually something's in the making right now as we speak. Something's really big is in the making, and we as people we're starting to see that, especially people consciously being here. We're starting to see some things going on. People are thinking different. Yeah, you got your little people who want to do their thing and going off on another tangent, but I mean it's part of life. That's part of life, you know. You can't win everything, right? As they say, just like Devil's Advocate, that movie. Oh man, come on.
Yep.
I'm a buff peep too. I'm a movie buff peep, you know. But I like the old school movies. The old school movies tell the stories.
Yeah, they tell a lot. They tell a lot, man. They tell a lot, man, about what's going on.
Yeah, so it's definitely some things we gotta really start paying attention to.
And
I was loving this part. I was loving this part too. The part when the Tin Man was actually holding his axe, and he said, "I've been holding this axe for ages." Come on.
Yep. He didn't know that he could cut through anything. He could cut through anything, man.
He'd been there. He claimed he was there for a year, but he was ages. Ages.
Yeah.
He said ages.
Yeah, that's what it means.
Oh, okay.
Ages. You know,
okay. Yeah. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
But,
just another sign. Just another. What brother's talking about is just another sign of Mercury, because the axe he carried was really like axe is from whoever the brother is. The word axe the etymology of the word is related to the word axe. That's what he's saying.
I feel,
and the axe really means ace. Ace is the etymology of axe. So remember, in a deck of cards, the only one above the king is the ace. you know, or God, one of the Axis powers of the world. You know, and that's what axe or ace means, that he was carrying, which shows another sign of what you call that Mercury head dime, the Roman deity Mercury, who was the god of commerce. And that's why Mercury was on the dime, on 10. The 10 signifying everything from 10 man to just 10% of the people who know the truth even. So there's significance, and everything around us is symbolic of all the farces that we find all the time in American, so-called American, traditions or ideals or definitions, which really aren't American in their context, but they're colorable and illusionary as far as being Americans, because the true Americans were the sovereign people who've been basically put to sleep by the people in world power controlling finance.
And matter of fact, you know, speaking of that Frank Baum, he actually, when he made the play, they was changing the play during his contract. They was actually changing some things during that period of time, during the early 1900s. They was changing some things in there, because he died in 1919, according to Winnipeg. And that's a bad resource. But I think throughout the time, it started changing. People started getting in, you know, since after the stock market crash, obviously, you know, 29 through, and they did the show in, or they did the, well, they made the movie in 1939 or before 1939, because you figure it took them a year to make the movie.
Right.
So,
right. Well, that's when Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer released it in actually 1939. And then they had an adaptation. There was an adaptation by other of our Jewish brothers, for instance, like Noel Langley and his brother, Florence Ryerson, Edgar Allan Wolfe. You know, and then
because that's where they all was. All of them
exactly.
was Jewish. No, they put it down during that period.
They put it down, and they was trying to. They was really trying to share with us exactly what the hell was going on. But they did have their people in position to consciously understand that covenant between themselves and who they were as spiritual beings. And as we can see from 1939 till now, even in 1933 when the money was gone, they still have been able to empower themselves from understanding truly what's going on.
That's it. And they've been doing it.
They've been doing it, man.
They've been making it happen for them.
And they did it unified and collectively. They did it unified and collectively, which is a real good thing to look at as far as example. They do everything unified and collectively, and that's how everything has to be did. They don't let you mess with them on no fronts. If you mess with them politically, they ruin your ass. If you mess with them in public, they ruin your ass. If you mess with them on TV, news, media, everything else, because they're covering all the bases. They're in news, they're in politics, they're in law, they're in entertainment, they're in everything that is on the face of the earth, because they've chosen to use their talents and abilities to be able to live the way that they want to live on their own terms without anybody having the type of control that they have over the whole citizenship. So they certainly have given us this so-called idea of what the heartland in America is, and it's not a car, it ain't Chevy, you know what I mean? It's the people. So we got to stop allowing them to use that whirling confusion in audio, video, print media, and in their educational system of his story as a means to rock the people to sleep. And then when you step forward boldly, claiming your birthright as being a reflection of God on the planet, you know, you mentally crazy, or you done lost your mind, or you're an enemy combatant, or you one of the crazy individuals that is here in the country that don't know what the hell is going on. It's really sad that they tend to always have those who have the knowledge and the intelligence to give us ideas about truly what is the worldview of what's going on. And we take those, and what it's called, like they used to do in Rome, kill the messenger, you know?
Come on.
So here he is with that message. Oh, man, we can't let him get that message out. Let's kill the messenger.
Yeah.
He telling too many people the truth.
Yeah, and that's the coolest thing about this technology, too. We got this medium to actually communicate with each other. You know, all these people sitting here on this call, you know, literally where we can actually explain some of the views, or not just, and like I said, you got to do your own research anyway. You got to really go and cipher this movie, cipher Wizard of Oz. I just picked Wizard of Oz because I thought it was a good subject. Plus, the metaphorically, it was right there. It was good for people's thinking. You can see literally who you are, what's going on. You always had the power. Nobody
always
needs to tell you you have the power.
Always,
you have the
always,
power. Y'all remember He-Man, She-Man on the show.
Exactly. Or if we look in terms on what's going on, here it is. They're controlling three energies, right? They have to control the physical energy, so they tell you that you got to eat three meals a day and have snacks in between. So your body is using all this energy to digest food, and you're clogging up your system for cancer, hypertension, high blood pressure, and everything else. Then they mess with you from the mental energy with the way that they have you using their traditions and their ideas on what historically happened as a means for your own mental training. And then they make sure they mess with you spiritually, because they give you a God. They give you a path to follow for your own enlightenment by telling you who it is that did A, B, C, and D. Without you worrying about going to the book and actually reading it, or going to the concordance and finding out about the chronology of it all or the history of it all, they want you to just sit there by somebody that they license and sent through a school of theology, teach you who you are between you and God by allowing him to stand in between you both. Oh, by the way, give me a tenth of your wealth also in this process, else you ain't going to heaven.
And think about this, brother. Think about this. They have you go sit down in these schoolhouses for somebody can be your master to
Absolutely.
Tell you what you need to know about sociology, anthropology,
Absolutely.
Psychology. Come
Absolutely.
On, people, we got to get a grip. We got to get a grip. About the law? Yeah.
Absolutely.
Come on, instead of going out and doing it on your own, handle your business. You know what you're
law, and the law speaks for itself. I had a couple of questions that to call your brother and ask him, too. But I'm going to say it once more, what law means, all right? For everybody that don't know what law means, here's law, okay? Land, air, and waterways. The whole planet.
Come on.
That's the law. The planet we're standing on is the law. You standing on the law every day of your life. So what you gonna do with this land and all this air and all these waterways? You gonna do what they tell you to do because you're a legal fiction,
exactly.
right?
Come on. No, that's real. That's real.
That's real.
You know.
Absolutely.
That's real, you know. And I think we fail to really question. We don't question our system, our authority, the so-called authority in our lives, you know. Or in our lives, and what I mean by our lives, who's in our minds, you know, who's actually have that influence or that impact or those
Absolutely.
Things that, you know, how your mom used to talk to you. You don't, your mom ain't nowhere to be around, but your mom talking to you.
Exactly.
When you know you're about to get in some trouble or do something you don't know, you know you shouldn't be doing.
Exactly. And the most profound aspect of that is, here it is that we always have had somebody to come to give us some light and illumination, because you have to have a so-called teacher or a guide to be able to understand these things. So here it is, TV, with that bullshit that's going on with the television. You know, that's what it is. It's telling your vision what to look at or view. You know, for everybody that don't know that, it's telling your vision what to look at and view, all right? That's for all the people who try to throw some rocks and shit, right? And then mass media, you know, is using the mental photography. Oh, here it is, brother, renting app. That's right. You got to learn mental photography in terms of understanding the things that we record subconsciously all around us all the time. So all the while you are awake, you know, if you allow it, your mind will outthink you. It'll talk to you all day. It's called mind chatter. It's a hyperactivity of your own energy. And until you control it, it controls you. So here it is. We have an outside faction controlling even that activity by putting in it what it wants to have. You know, as Brother Curtis say, right, monkey mind, right, with that monkey ball stuff. You know, you're exactly right, you know. And it's a universal law. So the universe itself still has land, air, and waterways, and yet time and space, which is another level of enlightenment. And then, as listener and learner said, right, mind chatter, perpetual preoccupation, right. So we're preoccupied with the things that have been induced in our mind by outside entities that have rocked us to sleep by its reinforcement being repetitious. So you go from kindergarten, well, pre-K now. You learn certain things in pre-K. Then you learn certain things in kindergarten. Then you go to the first grade. Then you go to the second grade. Then you go all the way to the eighth grade. Wow. Here I am in upper grade school. Wow, I'm really great. Then you get re-influenced and reattached again to it on the college level. So here it is, a universities that are all over the United States that are teaching people how their universe should be. Now here it is, you go to universities or universe cities, right, and you learn from them how your universe should be, all the way from the elementary grades, all the way through addicted to modern technological gizmos. So you're going to get the iPad and put all your information on it so they could track your ass. And they got a GPS in that too.
That's what they do.
Everything you want to talk about to your friend, you're going to text on your phone and think that information is just privy to you. Get out of here. then, instead of really recognizing that, you know, we have to interact with each other, human to human, flesh to flesh, spirit to spirit. Hell, I ain't even going to pick the phone up and talk to you no more to let you hear my voice. I'm going to just text your ass at this point.
Yes.
That's crazy. So we're being trained and dumbed down to do what's did, and that's right. You got to join a fraternity and make a mockery of your own sacred knowledge, see? And that's the whole thing. The sacred geometry that's been attached to the people has been taken from them by the people who want to have power and dominion and rulership over this planet. And they've allowed us to believe that everything that we're doing right now is truth, and it isn't.
And one thing, too, on that note is, like, I can see if you, well, it's your responsibility. I mean, you got to be accountable to all your actions, period, point blank. We got to stop giving this responsibility to somebody else. That's where it really comes down to. That's what I decipher. You know, you got to stop allowing these people to feed you, allowing these people to tell you what you look like, allowing these people to tell you what language you need to know. What is this? What you got to do this? You got to do that. You got to be this way so they can pull. Look, you got to go get a license to do law. Now, think about that. Everything you got to do, you got to get a license for it, supposedly. I'm just putting that out there. So they can just take it away from you when you're doing something wrong, or so-called breaking their law.
By the way, we're gonna revoke and rescind your driver's license, so you can't drive that goddamn $100,000 car you got in the driveway. Shit, that creates more liability and debt, right?
It's crazy, brother.
Matter of fact, let me get your passport up out you. You can't leave the country. You can't go to Hawaii or go someplace peaceful. You can't do nothing. You're either gonna stay right here, goddamn it, like we said, or else we're gonna lock your ass up.
That's what they do too, and they're good at it. They're good at it. You know, they're masters. You know,
gotta have a license to have a house. Gotta have a license to sell a house. Gotta have a license to buy a house. Gotta have a license to have a child. Gotta have a license to walk the street. Gotta have a license to marry your girl. You gotta have a certificate to die.
Yeah, it's sick. It's sickening. It's really sick. And we allow this, though, people. We allow this. We're not saying nothing about it. We need to have all these shows filled up, every one of them. Regardless, everybody should be talking about this. Everybody, we should be working as a collective, making it happen. Pulling our little called fiat dollars together and putting it down. Because we got now, see, the coldest thing, 20 years ago now? Roughly about 20 years ago now. We didn't have the internet going on. I mean, they had it for their elite people, but now we got it for the people. Now we can reach people all across the world. You know what I'm saying? Coming to a collective where we can actually meet on one medium. Even now, it's going to be so cold here in a minute that, like, Skype and all these other free services, they're going to be available so we can actually view each other and be right there locked in each other's, you know, right there in each other's face. So then we can do more interaction and coming together on some, you know, medium business deals or whatever the case may be, you know.
Absolutely.
Because I know on this call, I'm sure it's a lot of people who actually have great skills, talents, you know, whatever the case may be, you know. I'm I'm going to say this out loud. I'm better than Tupac, and I know. No, I'm joking. No, but no, my point is this. It's a lot of people on this call right now that actually have some skills in something. You know, we
Absolutely.
Always on this, aim in this for a mission. Everyone's
Absolutely.
Here on a mission. And literally everyone has a skill that is better than everybody else's on this call.
Absolutely.
And we,
that's what we should do. Pool our resources, become unified and collective on exactly coming out of that matrix. When we talk about The Wizard of Oz, we truly are in a matrix also. And that's another extraordinary film that people need to really pay attention to because
yes.
it had so many precise and so many incredible secrets to the knowledge of self that it was extraordinary. You know, and many other insightful ideas in audio, video, or print medium, you know, which is all information. I go back to that. Information is the key. So the information I have in my mind, information you have in your mind, the information that other has in their mind that it differs from ours has to be integrated. When we integrate those things, then the power comes from the circuitry involved. There's the true currency. It's not matter. I mean, it's not money, but it's the knowledge and the wisdom and the skill and spiritual mindset of the being that's the creation that's on the planet right now, which is land, air, and waterways. There's that law again, and we have to understand those things, and we have to be able to come back to ourselves and who we are. You could be purple and have three breasts or be pink with polka dot. Who cares? The main thing is that as spiritual beings, we're either going to have to do this collectively for our own survival, else we're going to continue to have the onslaught of death, debt, and chaos and destruction that the people in power are trying to put up on us to keep us from learning the truth about who we truly are.
Yeah, because I know, you could tell, like, people are getting tired. I mean, like Sam Davis, all these cats who's been doing it for a long time, they getting tired of saying the same thing, keep repeating the same information over and over again, because it's like we're not getting it. We're literally not getting it.
Nope.
And it's right here in front of our faces 24/7, 7 days a week. I know we've been brainwashed. I know we've been conditioned to think this
Absolutely.
Is what it is. This is what it is. But the key element, we got to start looking deeper. Even if you into the any kind of religion, look deeper into it. Find the root of the religion. How many times do we do that? We just, okay, I'm going to go with this. This is what it is. Boom, boom, boom. Keep it pushing. You know.
Exactly.
Oh, he told me this. Now that's, I mean, because everybody got a different interpretation regardless of what we look at it. Everybody
sure,
got
sure.
a different interpretation. Sure. But, I mean, at the same time, the interpretation, when you look deeper into that so-called religion, it comes all to the same resource.
Absolutely.
They
the
all come
resource.
To the same root.
Absolutely.
So it's no.
I love what Listen and Learn and Rentiep are talking about, too. And that's the whole thing. You know, when somebody asks you, well, what state are you in? Or, you know, like they do it on the phone all the time, Bill Connection. Well, sir, could you give me what state you're in? And that's what you should tell them. I mean, I'm in a state where I'm mostly liquid, solids, and gases. That's the state I'm in. I'm in a state of spiritual understanding, and I'm in a state of creative mind, you know. Or where do you live at? Should I live inside of my body? That's where I'm living.
Come on.
Right here
on,
in my skin, you know. So a geographical landmass should never be associated, a zip code, a geographical landmass, or something that someone else claims to be your state of being should be acknowledged by them. It should be acknowledged by yourself. And you can never change that state of being because you are the creation. So the fact that you are the creation and you're walking on law, land, air, and waterways, you have to understand that knowledge was the key for your manifestation. So if you came from the universal mind, then that means that you have to go back to the universal mind from where you came from in order to get more understanding about what your state of being and state of mind should be.
Why, and let me ask this, why are we independent? We can be independent on a lot of different things, but then when it comes to our life, we're not independent. We always giving credit to somebody else or giving credit to something else. You ever thought about that?
Yeah, I've thought about it in essence, my brother, and what I feel from that understanding, and maybe Kurt and Listen and Learn and Reattempt can probably, you know, augment off of this, is the fact that here it is, we are giving credit to things outside of us because that has been the nature of this artificial intelligence. They have never wanted us to recognize who we truly are. Who are we in itself? We have never been recognized for the creation that we are. We have been lulled to sleep, and we thought this process of living, the synopsis, you say, for living, has been outside of us. So here it is, you have the smart kids that overrule the EMH kids, or you have the fat kids who don't like the skinny kids, or the black kids don't like the Hispanic kids, or the white kids don't like the Asian kids. So they have used those means of illusion to create divide and conquer issues that detach the people from collectively understanding that our strength and our empowerment comes just like what we are. We're cellular. They take millions of cells to make one person, millions of atoms, millions of electrons, millions of protons, millions of neutrons, and yet all of them know their role and all of them know the definition of themselves in order for us to be successful in creating life.
Key point, you said role.
Exactly. Everybody
knows
their role. Electron know what it's supposed to do. Proton know what it's supposed to do. Neutron know what it's supposed to do in order for them to collectively be an atom.
They don't get no egos.
The atoms know where you know I'm gonna get down. I'm gonna get a whole bunch of us together, and we gonna make a molecule. The molecule says, "Man, I like that." So now I'm with this molecule crew. Let me go make a whole bunch of molecules, and yet, wow! Let's get with chromosomes and see if we could do different chromosomes and make different molecules. Everybody cooperating, but the creation itself. What should that tell you? Of course we're lost our mind. We can't even cooperate with each other. All of us are hues, men. We're different hues, but we're men, all of us. A woman is just a man with a womb. A human is just a different man. What hue are you? Oh, I'm an Asian hue because we were 20,000 degrees above sea level. Or I'm a black hue because we were over in Africa where the sun shines at its highest, so we had to figure out a way to adapt to the sunlight so that we wouldn't disintegrate from just the heat alone. By the way, I'm from the caves of Europe because I was like the Iceman and stuff, and I was inside, so I got a lot of hair on me, but all of us are human. And energy is energy, just like Kirk said. It's all energy. And the energy I'm trying to get people to understand, Brother Kirk, is not spelled the way that you spelled it. And Brother Hebrew know how I am about energy. Energy, my brother, is spelled INNERG.
It is.
The inner God in you. See? Because there is a God within you. There's a kingdom of God with you that's waiting to manifest itself when you recognize that you are your Father's creation. If you're the child of the Most High God, then stop playing with that. Be the God that you are. Instead of creating you're creating mischief and bloodshed on the planet as our little brother, because he was an angel, and he was an angel, right? But here it is, Dad wanted us to be like him, so he told him to submit. So Iblis wouldn't submit, so he's going to come down here with his nonsense. Well, you know what, Dad, since I'm an angel, and they just like you, they flesh, watch me get them caught up in everything. I'm going to have them caught up in everything. I'm going to have them doing drugs so they won't know who they are. I'm going to have them playing with this money that is an illusion. They don't exist. I'm going to have them at odds against each other because you fat, you skinny, you black, you white, you purple, you blue, you Jewish, you're a Gentile, you a Muslim, you a Moor, you whatever. Has nothing to do with anything. There it is one more time, hue being a man. So there are different hues, but man is the same. All of us are going to have to enlighten ourselves to the level of understanding where we really create and manifest the things that we want to will into existence, because you have that power.
But what they say, you got to put good things in to bring out good things.
You got to get good things out, absolutely.
And exactly. And that's what we're not doing. A lot of us are not putting good things in. We'd rather just let everybody else put what they want to put in there. Then we go off on them. We want to get attitude and tripping out. Oh, I can't stand it. I want to go off and boom, boom, boom. You can't be thinking like that. You got to start putting good things in.
Well,
so how to take possession of your own mind.
Exactly. That's why each of us trinkets, just like babies, right? You whine, you cry, so they pacify us. Like the brother say, here it is. People
come
out to withdraw from having their blackberries and their cell phones taken from them. Oh, man, I can't do nothing without my cell phone, man. Oh, come on, man, you're going to pick my cell phone. I ain't going to be able to do nothing. He really thinks his life is in a cell phone now. It's extraordinary. It's still outside of him. And how can you establish who you are if you don't understand your dominion over self? First of all, I want people to understand in this context too. When God said he would give us dominion and rulership, he meant you too. That big ass head on top of your shoulders is just like a sun. And
come
you
on.
Got nine systems in your body that's like nine planets that have to have the gravity of your insight and your wisdom and understanding to be able to rotate and create a system of solar from your solar plexus, the solar system. Here it is. We have a solar plexus in the middle of our chest. Solar, meaning sun, S-U-N, illumination. That's a very balanced and a very exceptional chakra. Here it is, the throat chakra for communications on how we get out. Communication being from the third eye of mind through the throat chakra, through the solar plexus chakra, which is all, once again, energy, the inner God in you. So here it is, we the children of the Most High God, and we rule by one of our little brothers who just like us. Come on, man. Are you serious?
But it's happening.
You know,
it's happening, and we
are telling me that I got to pay bills, and matter of fact, I'm going to make you give me all your money, but I'm going to print the money first and give it to you because I decide on how the money going to look. I took all your gold and silver, by the way. You know,
yeah,
so I'm gonna give you this money that I printed and shit. It's just like playing Monopoly. I'm the banker, right? You can't buy no properties unless you come to me, the banker, first to get some money that I got from you. Okay. And by the way, when I go past your property and stuff, I don't have to pay you rent. You got to pay me a mortgage for it because it really ain't your property. It's still mine, even though I sold it to you. You know. And if you keep playing games, I'm gonna come back and take it because I didn't get last month's payment from you.
Yeah, listen and learn. It's funny you say that, but because that's what's going on. We are giving the money. Well, we're giving them the money, but at the same time, if we give the money, and we are the children. We're acting accordingly as
exactly.
Children. That's how
exactly.
We're acting like.
Exactly.
You know?
Well, that was the Munchkins. That was the Munchkins in the Wizard of Oz. Remember the children? The Munchkins was just dancing and singing, follow the yellow brick road. Oh, the yellow brick
grown
road.
Man, huh?
Oh, the father, like grown man,
oh, man.
Like little babies,
grown
right?
Grown man and women.
That's why the Munchkins was put in there in the first place. Then you go to Emerald City where everything's green. Remember, the whole city is green, so they printed the money in green, right? Then when you go inside, everything is colorable. It's in colorable law. It ain't in real shit, right? It's color. All color all around you. It's just, you know, let's cut it out, man. It's like what Cat Williams say, the brother, the comedian. Cat Williams say, you got to be your own star player.
Yeah.
You're the star player. You're the star player, you know. Now, how am I going to play? Am I going to play like a star, or am I going to play like one of these burnt-out moons? You're either going to be a star and illuminate, or you're going to be a moon. See, a moon is another way of showing us illusion, because the moon don't have no light. How can we see it? Because it reflects light. It creates artificial light by taking somebody else's illumination and then shining it back on their asses.
Come on, come on.
Quick.
Oh, man. We having fun with this, people. That's the whole point of my sovereign world, keeping it pushing. I'm serious, brother. Just the giving people an opportunity to really, hey, listen to the real. You know, just that's what I love about Reese the Realist. You know, she put it down. Give it to you raw. You know, and that's what we here for. You know, kind of giving you some inside information on what's really going on. You know,
I can't do it any other way, brother. Because when I learn from you and my brother, man, you know, you, Nazir, and my other brothers, man, who on point, man, all it does is it reinforces the fact that I've always had a way of understanding what's going on, man. But, you know,
hello?
Can you hear me?
Hello? Oh, there
can
you
hear me? Yeah, I was saying that it's extraordinary in this context because when I have my brothers around me, man, and I can get there, I can galvanize or integrate with their energy, man, it's a beautiful thing. You know, you, my brother, you know, Brother Nazir, Brother Joshua, Brother Sutar, all you brothers who are absolutely giving me the examples that's needed to reinforce what I'm doing with myself and becoming who I truly am and understanding the universal law and the righteousness of truth and wisdom and knowledge, and to have brothers like yourselves to be able to have me to be able to get connected, because it wasn't a coincidence that all of us got connected, but to be able to have the type of energy from each one of you to reinforce what I'm doing, man, and give me that strength and that guidance that I need to establish what's supposed to be accomplished here right now in this consciousness that is evolving all over the face of the earth. To be one of those who are right out here in it, man, pioneering it, and to have those around you that have some concern about you and absolutely understand where we all is in the thing, our examples alone are going to create unification, going to create a collectivity that's going on right now that's going to push this stuff. And that's what I really like what you said. We all need to stay connected. We all need to use each other's talents and abilities. We all need to collectively understand that without each other, the divide and conquer that's been in full effect is going to continue to influence what our world should be. If we continue to let people fragment us and create these fractional ideas by their principles and their definitions on how life should be led, it gives you a disservice from this wonderful life that you have as a spiritual being. So until you connect truly to, like you and Brother Nazir always say, it's on you. You are the one. You are the person. Not the person. You are the spiritual being, because a person is artificial. So we got to keep it moving on that one, too, and stop allowing some of those things to come. But you can see that it takes a lot of thought, and it takes the processing of thought, and it takes the understanding of even yourself to get an idea on how to navigate this illusion that's around us. And believe me, it's been at a detriment of the people, and it's caused the chaos, the damage, the destruction, the wars even, that are all over the face of the earth with mischief and bloodshed. Imagine if everybody understood that we all are free. We all are the life, the liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, the freedom, the justice, and the equality that's been given to us by the Creator, not by some people on the planet that think that they run this shit. The only reason they run it is because what happens? We give them consent. We allow them.
We allow them. Exactly. We allow them. And that's the cool thing, and I appreciate you, brother. I appreciate all of you being here on this, you know, being on this call, you know, because even though I would have been on the call, it would probably have been myself just talking my thoughts and whatnot, but I appreciate you coming, sharing your thoughts, sharing that energy, you know, here, because really, we can't be nowhere without each other, period. That's where it comes down to, people. We literally can't do nothing without each other, you know, and that's where it's going to come, where we're going to start taking back control of what is ours, literally, what you run. You run in your life. You handle your life.
Yep,
you start being the master of your life.
Absolutely, and this goes out to my brother, Listen and Learn, and Nazir put it so eloquently, truth is the most profound frequency of vibration that has all of us tuned in and integrated and connected. And we've been dealing with fallacies. So our integration has become disconnected, because that frequency of vibration that is truth has enabled us. So somebody has used a resistor, as they use in electronics. So we have these resistors that are in place socially that inhibit us from having the frequency of vibration on truth. So here it is that I'm not going to associate us looking for the evildoers. How will we look for evildoers or people that are contained in an axis of evil if we continue to associate ourselves with evil itself?
Come on.
There's no reason for us to look for evildoers, because no one did evil or anything of that nature on us, but what happened was that lower earthbound energy, which is evil, sorrow, fear, anxiety, discomfort, misunderstanding, war, chaos, destruction. All of those are earthbound energies. So he's kept us earthbound by not allowing us to have the ascension toward heaven, which is in our mind, which is skyward, on top of our soldiers. So if we look from the ground, from where our feet is present, to our head, which is skyward, we've never looked to the sky for any type of knowledge. So there it is. Look in our own mind and our own brain by being who we are, and those levels of understanding will will make you capable of connecting to who you truly are, because that is the very vibration that is manifesting who we are in this physical reality. It's truth and righteousness. There is no power that's more profound than that.
Yeah, that's that old saying, in the world but not of the world.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So I don't really have time for evildoers, because I'm going to let them do their thing simply because they earthbound. And I'm looking from above. I'm not a chicken pecking at the ground looking down for some of them grains. I'm an eagle and a condor. I'm looking from above. So the evildoers is going to have to come up here and get me.
Mm-hmm. Now, let me take y'all back to that old movie, Jonathan Siegel.
Oh, you know what I'm saying? There you go. Well played.
Now,
that
see,
was
The Jonathan Siegel, if you can go find it, is a 1979 movie that came out way back in the day. But the movie is so deep. It's about a seagull that actually came in wherever he thought he was there. But it's so deep, you got to listen to the dialogue and what he's actually saying, because he meet this Chinese bird.
Yeah.
This Chinese seagull, and the Chinese seagull is off the chain. Y'all got to pay attention to it. But it's a deep movie. Y'all got to check it out. Jonathan Siegel. So if you get some time, go to the rack, or you can even put a torrent, find a torrent and find that movie.
Exactly.
Over here.
And that's the thing. And as my enlightened brother said, and that's exceptional in this context, and I want to springboard off of that. Certainly, there is a coming calamity, and it's necessary to weed out or destroy those who are out of frequency with this forward movement that we had, as Brother Nazir so profoundly put. But look at it in this context, too, because remember, we are within a war in itself, and this primordial substance, nature and universe, that is all around us is resetting the proper frequency or the proper vibration right now. And that attachment alone is in itself creating a vacuum even for the whole human family in their minds and in their spirit.
Mm.
So retroactively, we're revolving higher vibrational frequencies right now that are all around us, and that's why consciousness surpassed technology last year in the chronology. Your brother put a chronology up at his site too, Forever Together Brothers, .ning.com, whereas the chronology of the theology of time, just something that your brother had a sense of from his thinking, right? So the theology of time in itself as the alpha and omega, the cipher closes. Now it's coming to the acknowledgement of what's happening right now. And since consciousness surpassed technology last year, look at us using the technology in itself as a means to expand on consciousness. So this very chaos and this very war that's going on and the calamities that ensue are a part of our own spiritual beings having the very things that we need to do too. So it's happening within, and it's also happening without. So the changes we see all around us are absolutely right now at the same time happening within us. That's where the balance and the harmony comes from. So the tsunamis, the earthquakes, the fire, the discomfort, the weather, and this chaos and this structure on trying to find a means to clear and calm itself is the same thing that's happening with the spiritual beings that we are as a human family right now inside of us. And this
we got control. Yeah.
Exactly. You're the controller.
You got control of all that. You control all
that. That's the control
of
all that. But without a brother like you, a brother like Nazir, a brother like Listen and Learn, a brother like Kurt, or any of these other brothers who came to the forum today, just look at the insight that we all have in connection as we integrate with all of us know, how that empowers each one of us. Because what you have has a certain amount of knowledge and wisdom that I'm capable of using. What Nazir has, what Brother Joshua has, what Brother Lamar has, what Brother any of these individuals that are spiritual beings like us, we are all truly connected by that primordial substance that's all around us that in Star Wars that they call the Force. You know, we're talking about the same energy that's galvanizing all the time. It's right there in our face. It's right in our mind. It's right in our spirit. So Dorothy had the power all the time to click her heels and go back to her own reality, but she couldn't acknowledge it because she was too accustomed to looking at external guides as a means to define herself instead of going internally and absolutely talking to your spiritual self which talks to you anyway with the mind chatter and the hyperactivity of your own mind.
Come on. You're on point, brother.
Yeah, bro. And trying to get there. I'm just glad you little brothers have basically, you know, help your brother and feeling as though he wasn't out here by himself. Because, you know, I've been studying. Your brother been studying for a long time. And it's just a blessing. Just a blessing. You know what I'm saying? To see it happening right here in my face, to watch it manifest, and to watch my other brothers collectively and with the supreme understanding of who they are become who they are. It's all the way back to as it was in the beginning, so shall it be in the end. It's the Alpha and Omega, the cycle. There it is right there. So I see what brother talking about, the last dragon, right? Because he was the dragon all the time. He didn't know that he had power all the time. He let Shonuff them beat him up and stuff, you know. And
come on,
brother, getting the hell beat out of him. He couldn't catch no bullets in his mouth or nothing, so he realized that he was the master.
And figure
he
this,
was the master.
He had the glow all over his body. So that's what I'm saying to everybody. You got the glow all
you
over your body.
Glow.
Just gotta
you got
utilize it.
You got the glow, man. Hey. And what is it that floats? What is it that floats above your mind? A lot of people really, you know, if you look at these little cartoons and these punk movies, sometimes they always have truth in them. So look above your head. Right above your head is the cipher. It's a halo. It's gold and aura, and it has the brightness and the understanding of the creation from Alpha to Omega. So if everybody understood that the halo was floating above their own mind, here is that knowledge, that full circle, that's the cipher, that's above it, you know, and that's the name. Like Brother Nazir say, what's the name of the snake that eats its own tail? That's extraordinary, brother. All right, Nazir, you punching them in the stomach, bro. I love it, though, man. I love it.
But it takes us back to the root, and even though root is a little... It's deeper than what we think it is, because we don't know. Well, we do know if we keep reading and keep looking, you know, because the rabbit hole gets deeper and deeper, as we say all the time in this show. You know, you're going to find some knowledge, then that knowledge is going to get debunked. Then that knowledge is going to get debunked, because it just keeps going.
Yeah,
literally.
Yeah, and to my brother, guest number seven, absolutely, man, that's very true. That's very true, and that's the thing. We have to, and that's why Brother Nazir said that we have to collectively integrate all the knowledge that all of us have, get it in some kind of real bountiful, let's create some kind of format for the exchanges we have, which will create this formula or application for the wisdom and knowledge that all of us have. Else it's just like you said, it's just information. It's just sitting there. So we have to access it. We have to activate it by literally using it in the methods that create the awareness that we really have to have in consciousness. So that awareness alone has to have those things that we use as a means of formulating the application of it and using the information we have as a means to create the reality that we know is true and wholesome and truth and understanding.
And peep this. And the coolest thing about it, you have to give that information away. If you don't give that information away, what's the point? It's no point to your living, really. But
exactly.
You have to give that knowledge away.
Just think of every divine light and every guide that we had. Now, just think what Jesus, how far he'd have got if he'd have charged the people for what he know. Or Buddha. If Buddha would have charged all them poor people up in the Asian he'd have charged them for what they had. Or Noah would have charged people to get on the ark. You know, or Abraham would have charged people. Moses say, look, I ain't going back up to that mountain until y'all give me some damn fiat. So if I ain't bringing no tablets of law and knowledge down till somebody pay me. You know, just think about it. So we need to give this knowledge.
Bring it to
people that we're supposed to do, man. And we start right here, as Brother Nasir, with the baby steps. You are not a person, and you are not a Nami. You know, as Nazir say, what are you called, right?
Exactly. Come on. What are you called? You got many a names, too. Your dog call you Worth. Cat call you
Right.
You got Daddy. You got Mommy. You got, come
right.
on, people.
Right, you're right. You know, I got people that call me Sifu. They call me my brother, brother, master, you know, teacher, you know, father, daddy.
Oh, man.
You know, my boy.
That's crazy.
boy.
Yeah, exactly.
Old boy. What up, old boy? You know.
Connect talks you. Yeah, so it's just some insight. Just giving you some insight what's going on. You know, I like to do this more. I would like to do, I just want to keep people aware of what's going on this week. We actually got a really great packed week this week. Wednesday, we're going to be bringing in Doug Riddle. For those of you who are familiar with the A4V or acceptance for value processes, we're going to be bringing him on Wednesday, and that's going to be 7 o'clock. On the 12th. That's the 12th. Yes, that's the 12th. So 12th. I want y'all to be aware of that. What's going on? Have your questions ready so we can get in there, make it happen. Give them one of the best shows. Let's make this one of the best shows he ever had. Really, bro. We got people getting some remedies right on the call. And then Thursday, we're going to be doing a gift. We're actually going to be doing sovereignty and self empowerment. So, brother Nazir, brother Sadat, myself, and whoever want to come and join, you know, this is going to be more self-empowerment. Come on, thinking this is who you are, this is what you do, this is what we need to think, and yada, yada, yada. What do you think you are? So it's just some things on that level. So I just wanted to keep you aware. Our time is getting short a little now. It's about 4:43 right now, so, you know, they cut you off after 2 hours. But I appreciate you all coming through. I thank you again, once again, Sadat, for just that energy, you know, helping support. Oh, he's off. Are you off? Oh, he ain't even on the phone. But on that note, I'm probably going to call it an end right here. So those of you, I want to thank you again for coming out and supporting us. So Wednesday be our next call. And then Thursday we'll have our other self-empowerment. And we got a good one next week as well, following week Friday. So I want to thank you all for this, and I'm out.